What's going on, guys? So today I'm gonna replace the thermal paste on my old R9 290X, and I've never done this before, so let's hope I don't break shit. Now, kind of the idea behind changing the thermal paste on your GPU is if, you know, maybe it wasn't quite put on the best from the factory, or maybe it's been a few years since it was applied, so it's not as effective now. So possibly applying a new application of thermal paste could drop the GPU temps. So that's why we're gonna go ahead and try that today. Now, of course, before we pull this thing apart, I gotta get some baseline numbers. So the first thing that I did was fire up the FireStrike stress test, which runs for about 10 minutes, which should give this GPU plenty of time to heat up. And the max GPU temp I saw was 84C. So just keep that in mind for when we put this thing back together and retest it. We've gotta beat 84 degrees. Okay, so I've never actually done this before, and this is kind of my first time really taking this thing apart. I've removed this top fan shroud before, but I've never actually separated the cooler from the GPU or the PCB. So we'll see how this goes. I'm thinking it should be fairly straightforward though. So I think I actually don't need to take the fan shroud off. And in this case, first thing we'll wanna do is take off the back plate. So if you guys don't know, basically I've had this R9 290X since 2015. And this is a GPU where thermals like really matter. Like, even though this 290X has a super beefy cooler on it, thermals are still somewhat of an issue. So that's why I think this is actually the perfect application for me to do this on and test it out. Because if there's any GPU that I have that's gonna show a difference in temps with replacing the thermal paste, it's gonna be a card like this. If I haven't explained it yet, we're actually going to be using some Arctic MX4 thermal paste that we've got here. So I'm not gonna be using like any liquid metal or any crap like that, which I think you're not even supposed to use anyway. So yeah, hopefully we see a little bit of difference in temperatures with this thing. I did look up just like a couple tutorials or videos just to make sure, you know, I was doing what I was supposed to. Not that I didn't already have an idea, but you know, just to kind of make sure. So the back plate is off. We've got these screws around the actual GPU, which we'll want to loosen all the way now. There we go. Yeah, so it's got a VRM cooling plate on it. We do have some pads. I don't know if you guys can really see there on the heat sink over here. And there's a little bit of thermal paste on there. It's not too bad. There are some spots where it doesn't look like there's really any at all, but I don't know, it's not too bad looking. Cool, so that took like a couple minutes just to pull that off. That was pretty simple. All right, so now what we gotta do is clean this thing off. Little cotton pads here with some alcohol on it. So we'll just go ahead and clean that off. We'll get the top part off here too. So it looks like it's got thermal pads like over the memory chips right here, but really nothing else. I'm sure that actually there's probably pads under this cooling plate right here. I forgot about that. So this kind of sits over like your VRM components, which are on this side, and some other stuff there that needs to be cooled as well. And it looks like there is a little bit of padding I can see in the cracks there, but yeah, we really don't have to mess with that in order to change the thermal paste, so that's cool. Now, as far as like the application method for this thermal paste, I was kind of, there seems to be a lot of differing opinions, obviously, or of course, I should say. I've seen like, you know, when the water cooling companies, or the guys that produce like the water blocks, they want you to do like a star method. I've seen people just do like a dot, just like a CPU or the line method. I think I'm just gonna do a line. Oh shit. So, got that MX4 on there. So all we gotta do now is put this baby back together. That was pretty simple. This would be a good time probably to like blow out your heat sink or anything like that if it's super dirty. I've actually cleaned this pretty recently because I had taken the fan shroud off to remove Plasti Dip, so I'm not gonna worry about that for now. But yeah, just keep that in mind. feels like it's supposed to go lower, but it's not. What did I do? All right, warranty is officially voided, but this thing is pretty much back together. We just got to put the back plate on there. So let me do that real quick, and then we are going to throw this thing back in the system. All right, so that's pretty much it. It is done. That was super simple, man. That wasn't hard at all. That was like 10 minutes? We had that thing off and replaced and back on. So, all right, let's go ahead and throw this thing in the machine and fire it up. This system that you guys are seeing here, by the way, is getting replaced very soon. If you guys wanna see what I'm gonna replace it with, make sure you subscribe to the channel if you have not already. Oh, and if I didn't mention, the CPU that's running in here right now is the FX8370. Along with this R9 290X. All right guys, just completed the final pass of the Firestrike stress test, and the results are 82 degrees Celsius. So actually it was more like 81, and then it just barely peaked at 82 right at the end. So if you guys were keeping track, that means we have dropped 2 whole degrees for our efforts here today, which for about 30 minutes of our time is not too bad, but I will be honest, that's not a big change at all. So probably not worth it if you're concerned about warranty, but if you're just bored and you want something to do, hey, it dropped me a couple degrees, but it might be more for you though, who knows? So you know what I want? Actually, if you guys have done this before, make sure you comment down below the GPU that you're using, the thermal paste that you used, and your results. I wanna see if you guys had better results than me or if they were about the same. So yeah, leave those comments down below. Make sure you guys like this video if you like this type of content. Subscribe if you've not already. Make sure to follow me on Twitter and Instagram as well if you guys want behind the scenes pictures and stuff of what I am doing in my upcoming videos. And that's a wrap from here, guys. Until next time, see ya.